We were just talking about, knowing when to take a break. And, we're kind of circling this in a lot of ways, but I guess I'm wondering, what are some good guidelines for knowing that dating is taking up like the right amount of space in your life? You know, as you are dividing up your energies, it's really, really hard to know how much free time you even have when you're like living at home.
Sure. Yeah, there's an exercise that I really like where you divide the amount of time that you spend on different things into a pie chart. And you can do the same thing with your values. You divide those into a pie chart. And ideally, you want those to look similar so that the amount of value that you put on romantic relationships is correlated with the amount of time that you're spending pursuing romantic relationships. And that's going to look different for everyone, and that's okay. It's just a matter of matching your own priorities. If you really value your friendships, but you're spending 90% of your free time swiping through Tinder, those friends might feel neglected, and you're going to feel out of sorts because you're not spending your time in a way that's congruent with your values.
Well, how do you know when you are out of sync? I mean, what are some of the warning signs for when your reality doesn't line up with your ideal pie chart or your ideal investment?
Hold on, I need to take notes on this to make sure.
Yeah, for real.
Yeah.
This is a place where all of the poly folks in the audience are like with rapt attention.
Warning signs might be a sense of anxiety, a sense of resentment as you're going through and swiping, re feeling resentful that it's taking up too much of your time. That's definitely an indicator that, okay, so let's shift things so that it's not taking up as much as your time. Personally, I'm a huge fan of, on the iPhone, you can set limits on apps of how much time you spend on them. And you can also go back and look at the end of the week or at the end of the day at how much time you spend on all of these different things. So,
Life is hard enough without that kind of self-judgment in my life.
it can absolutely turn to judgment really easily. And it can also be nice to say, okay, well, I'm going to spend 30 minutes a day on dating apps, and that's it. And
No,
allowing
I
yourself
think there's a lot
to
of
be
value in
okay with
that.
that.
Yeah. No,
Or
I
an
actually
hour or
had
an
never heard
hour.
that strategy. I like that.
Yeah, I'm a huge fan. I have time limits for a lot of the different apps that I use. And you can always ignore them, if in the moment you're like, no, I'm having a great
This
conversation. I
is
want to
somebody I need to text with. Yeah.
Yeah, then you can ignore those limits and continue. But it's a good little reminder of like, hey, this is the amount of time that you said you wanted to spend and you've spent it. And sometimes it just needs that little push where it's like, oh yeah, I can set my phone down and do something a little bit different.
Establishing a baseline of your activity.
Yeah,
I like it.
nourishing
It's so
yourself in a
easy
different
just to
way when you
get
need to.
sucked into it.
It's a meat market, it's a Brazilian steakhouse.
It is.